Sir, Tamil Nadu is also part of India.
Sir, I am sure the key framer of the constitution and first law minister, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, will be turning in his grave.
An 18-year-old can choose a prime minister, can have a live-in relationship, can have a sexual relationship under POSCO Act, but you are denying the right to marriage. What have you done for the 18-year-old?
But today there are online educational companies which are worth billions of dollars. Some of them are worth even more than the entire educational budget of India.
Sir, thank you for calling me honorable. And if you really believe I'm honorable, then listen to me carefully.
But anything can be done. You can also manufacture a majority in Rajya Sabha by keeping 12 MPs outside. So anything happens.
This network is a step. This should be taken back. This is against the 18-year-old. Thank you.
Tamil Nadu has seen a record rainfall. This happens the third time in this last 200 years. The rainfall was similar to 2015, but because of the efficient steps taken by my Chief Minister, Sir M.K. Stalin, we have ensured the damage was very limited. And in fact, sir, the Tamil Nadu government has asked the Finance Minister for a restoration of the amount for 3,554.88 crores, which we are yet to receive. I take this opportunity to stress upon this, and same time also to remind our BJP friends and also the Prime Minister, when some similar incident took place in 2017 in Gujarat, the floods came. Within 3 days, 500 crores was released for Gujarat. Sir, Tamil Nadu is also part of India. I appreciate Gujarat's, the way Gujarat got the funds. We should also get similar funds, sir. So Tatas are taking, won the bid for 18,000 crores. A secrecy claim, who's the second bidder, who's the third bidder, we don't know. Is as secret as the PM Cash funds. We all want to know who are the other bidders. And only what we read from the newspaper, sir, it claims that the other bidder was SpiceJet, and one wonders where they had money, because already the courts are putting the SpiceJet in the bench, saying that they have to wind up the companies because they are not paid up the creditors. But sir, who was the... Sir, I'm talking. Wait. Nine. If you want to give it to me, give it to me. Sir, out of the 18,000 crores, sir, Tata's is paying only 2,700 crores as cash.
Yeah.
The remaining 15,000 crores has been taken in, as absorbed as debt. And the government of India is giving 68,000 crores to wipe out all the debt. Sir, Rishikant Dubeji has been always stuck in the memory loop. So it's 7.5 years since your BJP government is ruling the country. You still want to go to 2004, 2011. Why can't you start? We are in 2021. And the end of it. Sir, every time you want to start blaming from Jawaharlal Nehru to Indira Gandhi to Manmohan Singh, when are you going to own your responsibility? In 7.5 years, you could not turn a company around, or you made it worse. So this is a question. I'm not asking this question. Any common man with limited knowledge of economics might ask this question. When you are interested in putting 68,000 crores, why can't you put the remaining 18,000 crores and take the company and keep it running profitably? This is our national jewel.
Sir, India is a diverse country, sir. It's a very important point, so I need your benevolence to complete this. The present scheme of appointment ensures that only a particular class process are rewarded by the government. A new class is being created, sir. Of course, there are exceptions. I understand there are brilliant judges who come from judges' family. Sir, let me remind the law minister, only a process, thought process passed down. It's a diverse country, sir. With the expansion of the cabinet, sir, during the last expansion of the cabinet, it was said that the expansion includes sizable number of OBCs, SCs and STs. This will be the most socially diverse council of ministers in the history of independent India. Sir, that was a statement made by most of the BJP leaders. Sir, Prime Minister had ushered in an inclusive India for the first time. All the BJP spokespersons were vocal on that. I don't want to comment about that. Does it mean that when it comes to judiciary, we shouldn't want such a diverse representation? Should we be oblivious about that? You want only representation in the cabinet? Sir, out of 47 Chief Justices of India till date, at least 14 have been Brahmins. From 1950 to 1970, the maximum strength of the Supreme Court was 14 judges and 11 of them were Brahmins. Sir, 1971 to 1989, Kiran Reddy Saab. Sir, this is a point, sir. This is a point.
Please.
The government has successfully spiked the appointments of those who are inconvenient to them. Kiran Reddy Saab, you know what I am speaking. And the government has been sitting on the proposals of collegium whenever they find certain names who are persona non grata for them. Some judges are transferred for unknown reasons, sir. It's a punishment. But some chief justice openly speaks against secularism, which is against the constitution, sir. No age criteria for becoming a judge. Some are rejected for want of age. Some are appointed overnight, sir. I don't want to take names, sir, but can we be oblivious about Justice Agil Qureshi, who was not deliberately elevated to the Supreme Court? Wasn't his name proposed? Didn't the government sit on the file? Sir, what was his crime, sir? I would say that he was responsible in sending one of the powerful persons of this dispensation to jail. What else, sir?
This is against right to freedom of under Article 19. An 18-year-old can choose a prime minister, can have a live-in relationship, can have a sexual relationship under POSCO Act, but you are denying them right to marriage. What have you done for the 18-year-old? The woman labor participant force in India is lower than Somalia. Your Beti Bachao, Beti Padao, 89% funds were used by Narendra Modi for his publicity. This is a retrogressive step. This should be taken back. This is against the 18-year-old. Thank you, sir.
But today, there are online educational companies which are worth billions of dollars. Some of them are worth even more than the entire educational budget of India. These companies offer courses online which are not vetted by anybody. Nobody knows the content of these courses. Nobody knows the quality of these courses. Nobody knows the caliber of these courses. Nobody knows what is the caliber of the tutors who are on these who are conducting these courses. These companies now are engaging in predatory marketing practices where they prey upon the aspirational poorer people who want to give their children a better education, who want to supplement their education which they are not getting in government schools. They force them to buy courses and they auto debit their accounts. Even when they do not, when they want to even stop these courses, they can't stop these auto debits. These auto debits are happening regularly month on month. They in fact are becoming like loan sharks where they are forced selling these courses. And I urge upon through you, the Minister of Education, to bring about some sort of a system where we monitor these online educational companies which are worth billions of dollars, which are owned by major funds from internationally, which are thrusting these courses on the unsuspecting people of India and are auto-debiting their accounts. So it's very, very essential to do that, sir. And I also